Welcome to All India GK. Friends, here we are going to start with this new channel that is going to talk about the current affairs on a weekly basis. So starting with the December month of current affairs, ranging from 1st to 7th of December, this video is presented by me, that is Ayush Sanghi. This particular video is important for or will be useful for all the candidates preparing for banking examinations like IBPS, PO, RRB, RBI, etc. And there are many more examinations. This video will obviously be useful for the UPSC aspirants who are preparing for either ES, Civil Services, NDA, CDS examinations, or even for the SSC examination for whatever variant of SSC. So basically, this current affairs video is useful for all of the aspirants who are preparing for any government exam or who want to know generally about the current affairs section from various newspapers. Now, the newspaper coverage that we have tried to do is from holistic various dimensions. The very first issue is important from the point of view of Indian mainland, heart of Asia. This was in news in the first week of December, the first couple of days, where the finance minister of this country, that is Shri Arun Jaitley ji, he had led the Indian delegation in Amritsar to hold a conference which was known by the name of Heart of Asia. So every kind of rapport that India shares with Afghanistan has to be taken forward. So here a new vision has been established for increasing the cooperation and confidence between the two countries and between the region of India and Afghanistan. So this was started in the year of 2011. The main conference that will be held, it will be inaugurated by the Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji and Afghani President Ashraf Ghani. Afghanistan has been pushing for finalizing an effective counter-terror framework to deal with terror at the conference, which will be attended by the representatives from over 30 countries, including China, US, Russia, Pakistan, and Iran. So basically, the Afghan government is in for a peace process. So this was the Heart of Asia Conference 2016 that was held in India. The second piece of current affairs focuses upon the ultralight howitzers. This is an important piece of current affairs as this is the first deal of artillery that is signed after the very famous Bofors deal that was there in the 80s. So the first deal for artillery guns since the Bofors scandal in 1980s is by the name of ultralight howitzers. India and US inked a deal or signed a deal worth these many crores to deal with 145 M777 ultralight howitzers. These are a type of guns where it will be deployed near the borders with China. So basically on the Indo-China border, this will be deployed. The guns somewhat look like this. You can have a look at this particular figure. This deal was inked in a meeting of the 15th India-US Military Cooperation Group, MCG, where the focus was on increasing the ties and protection of our country from the porous borders. So this deal was recently cleared by the Cabinet Committee on Security, the CSS, Ultra Light Howitzers. Please remember this name. This can be asked as an MCQ question. Coming to the next piece of current affairs is the Aadhaar card. Aadhaar is a very famous program that was launched by the erstwhile UPA government. It was launched by the UPA government and recently the UN has recognized the Aadhaar card by specifically saying that India's Aadhaar is a critical step in enabling fairer access to government services. Fairer access means transparent access without any kind of non-transparency. So everybody who needs to have access to government services can do it through the use of Aadhaar card. So UN has said that Aadhaar has a tremendous potential for fostering inclusion. We are focusing on something by the name of inclusive development. Inclusive development means that every single person of society, whether poor, rich, has to be reaping the fruits of development. And this inclusion can be fostered by the use of Aadhaar card, because Aadhaar is a card where every single person can have focus on its Aadhaar card of development. So the report in which this news was broken was by the name of World Social Situation. Because Aadhaar card is something that focuses upon social inclusion and benefit for society, hence Aadhaar is focusing upon the same. So it focuses upon the UN card. So this was given by the UN Department of Economic and Social Affairs in this report, World Social Situation. So the next piece of current affairs is focused on yoga. Yoga has been included in UNESCO's representative list, where it has been recognized as a good social practice, a good tradition which can be followed for benefit of health, and which includes good amount of ancient and scientific knowledge. So this has been identified as the intangible cultural heritage. I repeat, this has been identified as intangible cultural heritage, and the recognition has been given by UNESCO itself. So intangible cultural heritage, and this is considered to be the 13th intangible cultural heritage that has been listed from India so far with UNESCO. You also would like to know that we celebrate the International Yoga Day on the 21st of June every year. This has been done by the consistent efforts of our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, on the international level. So I hope you are proud of yoga being included in the international list of days. Next important current affair is Jallikattu. Jallikattu is a bull taming sport which is from the state of Tamil Nadu. So, Tamil Nadu mein se jo bull taming sport hai, usko Jallikattu kehte hai. Jallikattu has been excessively in news because of its violent nature, where bulls are being harmed and the people are killed because of the bull taming sport. So, the Supreme Court sought to know why the center had negated its judgment on Jallikattu. So, the central government had negated the judgment on Jallikattu, which was given by the Supreme Court. So now Supreme Court has questioned the central government that why did it have to do it. So let's understand about the issue of what happened. The notification has come by the bench of Supreme Court, which allows bulls to take part in the sport again. Now, why was this an issue? This was an issue because bulls are being harmed in the process and it is a dangerous sport, so people are being killed. The central government had negated the judgment, but now the central government has assured Supreme Court that there would be no suffering for the bulls during the sport. The Jallikattu sport is also known as the bull taming sport, which is played in Tamil Nadu as a part of this festival by the name of Pongal festival. Pongal is a harvest festival which is from the southern part of India, specifically Tamil Nadu. So remember the name of the sport as Jallikattu. Next important piece of news is from Haryana, where Haryana has done an unprecedented move from the point of view of making Aadhaar accessible to the people of the country, or to the students of the country, if I may be particular. This move is also a move included within social inclusion process. So students of class 10 and 12 from the Board of School Education Haryana have been mandatorily asked to have Aadhaar card. If they do not have Aadhaar card, they would not be allowed to sit in the 2017 examination. The use of Aadhaar will prevent forgery of certificates. There would be no forgery, so genuine candidates would be writing the exam and filling up the form. Impersonation cases. Impersonation means where somebody personates as someone else and writes the examination or sits in the exam on someone else's behalf. And to ensure that the candidate's details are complete and accurate, this is a very, very unprecedented move in order to stop these kind of malpractices. So Haryana being the state where it has linked education to Aadhaar and education to appearing for examination through the Aadhaar card. A very, very good move made by the Haryana government. A new disability has been included in the Disability Law, which is Persons with Disability Act. So Persons with Disability is a particular act which is set to be tabled in Parliament that lists 21 infirmities. Infirmities means that people are disabled to do a particular job. The people falling under these 21 categories will be recognized as disabled and eligible for affirmative action and benefits under the laws. Hence, they will be provided many facilities for them to come out of such kind of disability. So this list of 21 infirmities has been added with the Parkinson's disease, the famous Parkinson's disease, and the acid attack survivors. So this would be considered a disability under law. Parkinson's disease is an important and a famous disease. It is considered to be a neural disorder or a nervous system disorder. So disorder of central nervous system that affects the motor system of the entire body, the thinking pattern, the behavioral problems are changed. So it leads to some kind of dementia that is considered to be Parkinson's disease. So please understand that Parkinson's disease is a disease that was there with boxers like Muhammad Ali. He had Parkinson's, and there were many other people, celebrities, who had Parkinson's disease. And acid attack is a problem which many girls or women or children, girl child, are facing in this country. So now any person suffering from these two kind of diseases would be considered to be disabled under the PWD, which includes 21 of these laws. Another info is that April is Parkinson's Awareness Month. So know about these diseases of Parkinson's, because this has been included. So this can be asked in MCQ format in any examination, the new disability. A first cycle highway has been made. So Asia's first cycle highway is made in the state of Uttar Pradesh. So it's a 207 kilometer long cycle highway. So just think that cycles will be running through the entire highway. So it's a very innovative concept that would run between Etawah and Agra, constructed by the UP PWD department. So it connects almost 92 villages, and it would be very convenient to villagers who mostly travel by cycle or two-wheeler in order to reach from one place to another. So it would be very, very helpful for the transportation. A very important piece of news from the point of view of Niti Aayog, erstwhile Planning Commission. Niti Aayog is a new body that was made when the Planning Commission was disbanded. By disbanded, I mean Planning Commission was over. So Niti Aayog, under the banner of Union Government, it constituted a committee specifically to promote the cashless economy. So this was done after the demonetization drive by the Prime Minister. It will be headed by the Andhra Pradesh CM, Shri Chandrababu Naidu. Amitabh Kant, who is the Niti Aayog Chief Executive, will be the Member Secretary of this body and would be assisting the CM, Chandrababu Naidu, in promoting cashless economy. So here we have specific objective by the Niti Aayog in order to promote cashless transactions through digitization or through digital payment system. I repeat, we have to promote this through digital payment system across the country. The best global practices primarily based on digital payment will be identified, and people will be given access to this to use in order to prevent them from payment in the form of cash. So please remember one thing, that the aim for Niti Aayog is to create the involvement and participation within the economic policy process of this country. So it would want the economy to be stable and the economy to run where it could contribute towards the growth of this country. Niti Aayog. The first cashless village, you will be surprised to know that Dhasai village in Thane has become the first cashless village in the state of Maharashtra. So pehla cashless village hai, Dhasai village naam hai, Thane mein padta hai ye, Thane district mein, which is considered to be the first cashless village of the state. So this was announced by the Maharashtra finance minister. So just try and think that every single transaction, right from purchasing the smallest to the biggest thing, can be done through the use of plastic money. So all the people like vegetable sellers, fruit vendors, others providing goods and services in Dhasai are using or going cashless for this part of transaction. Another kind of trivia that I would like to tell you, which you may find interesting, that the entire demonetization drive which has been running through the entire country in the last 1 month, here the one particular village within the state of Gujarat where the life is as normal. So this is considered to be the Akodara village. It's a tiny village situated in the Sabarkantha district of Gujarat. So this was the first cashless village of India. I repeat, Akodara was the first cashless village of India. But the first cashless village of Maharashtra is the Dhasai village. Cashless village. Now coming to Navy Day. We celebrated our 45th Navy Day on the 4th of December. So please remember this date, 4th of December, for Navy Day, and this was the 45th Navy Day. So the day is observed on the 4th of December every year to celebrate the magnificence, achievement, role of the naval force of the country. So as you know that India has a long coastline, hence The protection of the harbors, the protection of entire coast is extremely important. This is being done by the Indian Navy since independence. A little trivia about the Navy. The Indian Navy played a significant role by running an operation by the name of Operation Trident. It was launched on the 4th of December, and this particular operation was focused upon bombing the Karachi harbor. So it played an important role. Presently, the naval commander is Mr. Sunil Lamba. Please remember the name. He is Mr. Sunil Lamba. This person is appointed by, or the person who is appointed at this post is appointed by the President of India, and he has a term of 3 years, or at the age of 62, whichever is earlier. So either he will turn 62 or he will serve the entire term of 3 years, whichever is earlier, he will accordingly retire. So this kind of similar appointment as well as retirement term is of High Court judges. So please remember this kind of information for the MCQ purposes of the examination. World Ayurved Expo. So there is a ministry for the particular purposes of health by the name of Ministry of Ayush. It has organized the 7th World Ayurved Congress in Kolkata. Kolkata it organized, and it was a World Ayurveda Conference. So this Ayurveda Conference had been focusing upon the importance of Ayurveda and what kind of relationship do Indians have with Ayurveda. So it is the health benefits of Ayurveda, which is why this conference was held. West Bengal State Government and Shripad Nayak to inaugurate the Arogya Expo at the Ayurveda Congress. So this was being done at the World Ayurveda Expo. Next is UNICEF Nutrition Survey. You already know about the UNICEF. It is a body, a UN body that focuses upon children education and children development. So UNICEF has collaborated with the Indian government to conduct a national level survey which would measure the nutritional level of children across the entire country. India is a country where small children suffer from malnutrition or malnourishment. According to the survey, the data aims to quantify the micronutrients, this is the first important thing, vitamin and mineral deficiencies, as well as worm infestation among children. So, what are the level of micronutrients and vitamins that they are taking? What are the deficiencies that they have? And how much worms have they infested within themselves? This is being focused upon within this nutritional survey. So, a total of 120,000 children in the age group of 0 to 19 years will be surveyed within this survey. So, this is a very, very important survey specifically for a country like India. So, please remember some facts about UNICEF. UNICEF is United Nations Children's Fund. The headquarters of UNICEF are located in New York. What is the aim of UNICEF? It provides humanitarian and developmental assistance to children and mothers in developing countries. So, the way it is doing it for India, it is basically assisting children and mothers for having a healthy lifestyle within this country. This is a nutrition survey. Now, coming to the international dimension or the international news as well as every piece of news within this video has been covered from all the leading dailies or all the leading newspapers like The Hindu, Indian Express, Times of India, etc. So, please be focused upon all these current affairs. These are complete in every matter. So, we'll be coming out with every single video on a periodic basis. Now, the first important international piece of news is the World AIDS Day. On the 1st of December, the world observed the World AIDS Day. The people suffering from AIDS, which is known as the acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. I repeat, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So, protection of people who might get AIDS and the people who are already suffering, their cure has to be understood within this day. So, this day attaches its importance to AIDS as a disease and to the specific level, which is HIV, that leads to something like AIDS. So, the first stage is HIV. This is human immunodeficiency virus. This virus has no cure as yet. So, World AIDS Day is observed across the world on the 1st of December. The theme for 2016 World AIDS Day was Hands Up for HIV Prevention. Please remember this motto of World AIDS Day this year of 2016, Hands Up for HIV Prevention. According to UN AIDS report, more number of people are on HIV treatment, leading to fewer number of deaths. Look, HIV is a primary stage. when HIV increases over the number of years, it leads to something like AIDS. So if HIV can be treated, if HIV people or HIV positive people are treated well, it would lead to fewer number of deaths because then their disease would not progress into AIDS. However, it continues to be a major health challenge which is looming over the entire world because the cure is not yet there. Cure is yet to be discovered. Nearly 37 million people are living with the virus, the HIV virus, at the end of 2015. And this is a figure which has been verified by the WHO, World Health Organization. Now coming to the next international relations, the Thailand King, a person by the name of Vajiralongkorn, Maha Vajiralongkorn, was sworn in as the King of Thailand. He was proclaimed as the King of Thailand. This decision came after King Bhumibol Adulyadej, who ruled the country for several decades, passed away this month. So Vajiralongkorn, having certain information about him, he is 64 years of age and he has inherited one of the world's richest monarchies as well as the politically troubled nation, that is Thailand. So he becomes Ram X of Thailand's Chakri dynasty but will not formally be crowned until after his father's cremation next year. So please remember, the new Thailand king is by the name of Vajiralongkorn and he is succeeding Bhumibol Adulyadej. UNESCO's intangible heritage list, this we saw just a little while back pertaining to yoga. So Cuba's sensual rumba dance. The rumba dance is a dance like this where you have a person, a male and a female, who are dancing with each other, and Belgium's thriving beer culture. So these are two things. One is Cuba's sensual rumba dance and Belgium's thriving beer culture have been added to UNESCO's coveted list of intangible heritage. So remember that where does this dance belong to? Cuba. And where does the beer culture belong to? It belongs to Belgium. The list of this culture treasures was created 10 years ago, mainly to increase awareness about them. So this is extremely important for remembering this as an MCQ question that can be asked in any of the examinations. The full form of UNESCO is the United Nations Educational, Scientific, Cultural Organization. The headquarters of UNESCO are in Paris. Please remember this fact. They are in Paris. The purpose of UNESCO is to contribute, jaisa ki aapne dekha, it contributes towards adding the heritage list of the entire world. So contribute to peace and security by promoting international collaboration through educational, scientific and cultural reforms, adding culture to the entire world. So please remember these some facts about UNESCO. So UNESCO also provides the financial and technical support to countries who are fighting this kind of problem in order to save the culture of the entire world. So UNESCO's intangible heritage list. Next is International Day of PWD, Persons with Disability. We observed International Day of PWD on the 3rd of December. So International Day of PWD on the 3rd of December, World AIDS Day on the 1st of December. The theme for World Disability Day was achieving 17 goals for the future we want. So there were 17 targets or 17 goals vis-a-vis disability that have to be achieved in future, which were inscribed by this Disability Day. So Disability Day is promoted by the United Nations since 1992, and as you know that we are focusing upon disabilities with the basic aim of making the people who are affected by disability to feel that they are a dignified part of the society and they can also live a very, very good life just like the normal people. And the second aim of PWD Day or recognizing PWD Day is to make or raise awareness about the benefits which disabled persons have. So it's a very unfortunate part that the disabled people are not aware of the benefits that they carry with themselves. So they have to be specifically made aware of these benefits. International Day of PWD. Next is Malaysian PM's protest. Malaysian PM is by the name of Najib Razak. So this person is the Prime Minister of Malaysia. He protested a rally against what he called as a genocide of Myanmar's Muslim Rohingya community. Remember the name of this committee or this community by the name of Rohingya. So this is a minority committee and the Muslim minority committee of Myanmar. So there was a genocide. Genocide means there was a mass killing of the Muslim Rohingya minority committee within Myanmar, which is why the Malaysian PM held this kind of protest. So he said that Asian neighbors and the UN step up the pressure to stop the violence against this kind of community. So please remember the name, it's Rohingya. The plight of Rohingya in predominantly Buddhist Myanmar has galvanized Muslims in Southeast Asia and beyond. So this is very dangerous for the world if the Muslims start having that anti-hatred if Muslims start having that anti-sentiment or a hatred sentiment against a particular government, which is why the Malaysian PM protested. Sanctions are imposed on Iran by US. Again, US has imposed sanctions on another country by the name of Iran. So US Senate has passed a legislation unanimously to extend sanctions against Iran by 10 years. So sanction means that there is a kind of penalty for not obeying the law. If you do not obey the law, there will be some kind of penalty which will be levied. So the same penalty has been levied by US on Iran because it did not adhere to certain things that were said by the US government. So it was forwarded to President Barack Obama because Barack Obama was the president, is still the serving president until his term comes to an end, who is expected to sign it into law, dealing any potentially tougher actions until next year. So Iran warned that this would violate the Iran-US nuclear deal. US lawmakers denied the allegation and said it was necessary to extend the sanctions against Iran. So it has been extended by 10 years. Now coming to a very important piece of news, this is Trump's team. As you know, Donald Trump is a person who has won the US presidential elections and he is the new president for United States of America. So US President-elect Donald Trump has named General Motors CEO Mary Barra to his economic and job creation panel. So Trump's team has a very, very dynamic reach and a very dynamic aspect to create US into a job-spinning and employment creation country, where it would contribute to country's growth, national income and GDP. So Mary Barra, remember this name, she is the General Motors CEO and she would be heading the economic and job creation panel of Trump. Next is the panel set to meet for the first time in February consists of CEOs from JP Morgan, Chase, Walt Disney, Boeing and other companies. So Barra is one of only two women on the panel, the other being IBM CEO Ginni Rometty. Remember these two names, and these are important names because these are the only two women within Trump's team. Donald Trump has also announced that he will be appointing James Mad Dog Mattis as US Secretary of Defense. So James Mad Dog Mattis is the US Secy of Defense that would be looking after the defense aspects. This is a big team of Trump that he has created for the purposes of security, for the purposes of economic growth and proper job creation. Now coming to the economic current affairs. So economic current affairs are focused mostly on the demonetization drive that was announced by the Prime Minister this year on the 8th of November 2016. The cash withdrawal. The RBI has placed fresh curbs on cash withdrawals. Account holders can withdraw a maximum of 10,000 per month. Withdrawal limit is Rs. 5,000 from non-KYC accounts. So non-KYC accounts limit has been 5,000. Otherwise, it is 10,000 per month. The move has been taken on concern over the Jan Dhan Yojana. Jan Dhan Yojana is the biggest scheme of this country for the purposes of financial inclusion, where the bank accounts are being opened by people on the basis of no frills. No frills means zero balance accounts can be started. So what happened after demonetization is that you already know people started standing in queues and were depositing funds. So under Jan Dhan Yojana, the bank accounts were being used for money laundering. Money laundering purpose, because people were giving money to those people who already had accounts and they were depositing it in the Jan Dhan Yojana account. So as against this, customers can withdraw up to 24,000 every week from regular bank accounts. So because in order to stop this money laundering activity, what was done is that limits have been revised in the last week or in the first week of December or in the last week. So please remember this cash withdrawal limit. This limit may change in future. So if the limit changes in future, when we come out with another video, we would be revising these limits too. Now coming to the next important economic current affairs is about CRISIL, which has forecasted the GDP. Now CRISIL, please remember, is an analytical global company. So it's a global company and it analyzes or it rates the country on the basis of its economy. Rating means it would give a rating like AA or AAA or AAA plus on the basis of how the company's economy is performing. So CRISIL has lowered the country's GDP. It has decreed the country's GDP, India's GDP growth forecast by 100 basis points. Now please remember this economic current affairs, that 100 basis points BPS equals 1%. So if it was 5% earlier, now it would reduce to 4%. So earlier it was 7.9%, now it has reduced to 6.9% by CRISIL. This agency has said that CPI or Consumer Price Index based inflation to be at 4.7% as compared to earlier estimate of 5%. CPI is a measure of inflation. Please remember these important terms of economy because these can be asked in the MCQ format. CPI is a measure of inflation in the Indian economy and around the world also in any economy. So Kreisel noted that there is uncertainty on how much time it will take for the economy to return to business as usual, when everybody will have sufficient cash in their hands, when everybody would be having a spending power, then Kreisel would be rating the country high. But right now it is not business as usual. It is the GDP forecast has been lowered by 1% by this international agency. Next is Vittiya Saksharat Abhiyan. Vittiya Saksharat Abhiyan is a program which has been launched by the HRD Minister of India, Mr. Prakash Javadekar. So the basic aim of this entire scheme is to run the centrally run education institution. By centrally run, we mean the education institution which come within the central government for propagating the benefits of digital mode of payment in the wake of government's demonetization move. So digital mode of payment has to be increased, or digitization has to increase, and the youth of this country is being motivated to encourage people in order to use the digital mode of payment. It will actively engage the students of higher education institutions to encourage and motivate all the players by peers and payees. So peers and payees can be their parents, can be their relatives, can be their friends, can be their teachers, everybody, to go the digital way and to use the digitally enabled cashless economic system for transfer of funds. So if you have to transfer funds, you can transfer through the Vittiya Saksharat Abhiyan. The institutions of higher education in the country, faculty members, students, to take the lead and act as engines of transformational shift. This is known as Vittiya Saksharat Abhiyan. Please remember the name of the scheme from the point of view of empowering digitization. New bonds have been issued by RBI. So the name of this bond is Market Stabilization Scheme, and the bonds are MSS bonds, which are being sold by RBI to the banks on behalf of the government. So the government has issued the bonds. RBI will be acting as a mediator to issue these bonds to the government, to the banks, and in exchange raise some money. So government has created provisions to issue special bonds to absorb the temporary surplus with banks created by nationwide deposits of demonetized drive. Now let me explain a basic trivia to you. What happens is when the people, so if people deposit the money in a bank where the entire banking aspect has increase in money, so bank has increase in money. When bank has increase in money, it can give out as more loan. Loans can be higher. When the loans are higher, people have more spending capacity. When people have more spending capacity, inflation in the economy goes up because of higher money supply. So what has the government do to reduce this inflation or temporary supply of money in the economy? It has issued the bonds. The government will issue the bonds. The banks would pay money to buy these bonds, and automatically the money supply in the banks would decrease. And when that would decrease, so automatically the surplus that has been created, it will decrease. So inflation would not rise. This situation will not come. So please remember this about the new bonds of government which have been issued. A little trivia about the MSS. MSS scheme was launched in April 2004 to strengthen the RBI's ability to conduct exchange rate and monetary management. These securities will be issued by way of auctions to be conducted by the RBI. So RBI will conduct auctions and the banks will buy these kind of securities. Utkarsh Small Finance Bank. So Utkarsh Small Finance Bank is a finance bank that would cater the needs of banking for the customers. So it is a kind of micro finance institution, a small financial institution that would act as a small finance bank, and it would start the operations of a bank. So it's a Varanasi-based bank, and it has received a license from the RBI to operate as a small finance bank. Please remember the name. It is Utkarsh Small Finance Bank. In October 2015, Utkarsh Microfinance had got the in-principle approval to set up the SFB as per the guidelines issued by the RBI. SFB means a small finance bank. So right now it is functioning as a small finance bank within the state of UP. Next, the GDP estimation by the CSO. CSO is an important organization which has all the statistics to itself, Central Statistical Organization. So GDP of the country for the second quarter, which means from July to September, that is July, August, September, for the fiscal year 16-17 accelerated to 7.3% as compared to 7.1% for the first quarter. So CSO said that we have increased, or our fiscal year growth has been made from 7.1% to 7.3% in the first quarter, which is a good kind of growth in GDP. So GDP of the country can be defined as the total number of goods and services sold in the country of whatever value. So whatever value goods and services are sold, if that value increases, we say that the GDP of the country has increased. So it is the total monetary value of all finished goods and services. I repeat, total monetary value of all the finished goods and services that are produced within the country's geographical borders. Within the country, whatever has been created, that has to be sold in a specific time period. It is considered to be GDP of that, GDP increase of that economy. Some facts about CSO you have to remember. This is an important organization. So CSO falls within the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, MOSPI, and this is responsible for compilation of all the statistics on a national level, national account statistics, etc. At the state level, the state directorates of economics and statistics have the responsibility of compiling the state domestic product. So these are two agencies. At the central level, it is a CSO. At the state level, it is DES, who have the job of compiling state domestic product. This is GDP by CSO. Now coming to the science and technology news. The science and technology news focuses upon the new elements in periodic table that have been added. So there are four more elements that have been added within the seventh row of the periodic table. So periodic table, as you may remember in school, we studied, it looks something like this. So this periodic table has a list of chemical elements. I repeat, this has a list of chemical elements. This list was first published by a person by the name of Dmitry Mendeleev in 1869. This is a very interesting trivia. So this person had listed the chemical elements in a specific table, and this table is known as the periodic table. So this table has added four elements. These are nihonium, moscovium, tennessine and organosine, which have atomic numbers as 113, 115, 117 and 118. So periodic table elements with atomic number like 113, nihonium, has become the first ever element to be discovered by an Asian country. So nihonium has been discovered by Japan, which is the first Asian country to have discovered an element within the periodic table. So International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, IUPAC, has announced the names of been officially approved. So please remember this fact that four new elements have been added by the name of nihonium, moscovium, tennessine and organosine. So if you have, or you can derive a code out of it like NMOT, NMOT or NTOM on the basis of this, nihonium, moscovium, tennessine and organosine. Next is about a satellite, Chandrayaan 2. So Chandrayaan is a very ambitious mission of ISRO. Now ISRO is working upon Chandrayaan 2. Chandrayaan 2 is the second mission to Moon. Chandrayaan 1 was focusing upon the Moon mission, and it used to orbit around the Moon. This is an Chandrayaan 2 is an advanced version of previous Chandrayaan 1 mission. It is a totally indigenous mission. After the success of Mission on Mars, which was a totally indigenous mission, now the government is focusing upon the Chandrayaan 2, which is also an indigenous mission, comprising of the orbiter, lander and rover. Chandrayaan 1 is India's first mission to Moon, and it was launched in the year 2008. Now Chandrayaan 2 is being worked upon, and it would be launched very soon. So remember the name of the satellite, remember the name of the institution that is working upon this satellite, and it is a totally indigenous mission, and it is a mission to Moon. Next important topic is about Team Indus. So Team Indus is an aerospace company. It's an aerospace company which is working out in order to make a spacecraft. Please remember, it is making a spacecraft which would be landing on Moon. So their objective is to make the spacecraft land on the Moon in the year December 2017 aboard an ISRO rocket. So what is it? The aim of the mission is to land the spacecraft on the Moon and have it travel at least 500 meters, which is half kilometer, and beam high definition video images and data back to the Earth. So if data back to the Earth can be transmitted and it can land on it, it would be a very big step for the mankind. So Team Indus has high-profile investors like Ratan Tata of the Tata Group, 100-member team of engineers, space enthusiasts, former Air Force pilots, etc. So remember the name of this team or this aerospace company, it's by the name of Team Indus. Next is something about a detail about nuclear fuel, which was excessively in news. So nuclear fuel, as you may know, that nuclear fuel is used in nuclear power reactor, which is a uranium oxide pellet composition. So the entire nuclear power reactor, it functions in certain stages like stage 1, 2, 3, etc. So this new technology of making available low cost method for producing high quality nuclear fuel, which is by the using of electricity, what can happen that these kind of, what will happen with this new technology is, it would allow one to obtain products of high quality, that is high quality nuclear fuel, and to reduce number of stages. So you would not have to go through these three stages or more stages, and this number of stages used would be reduced. So this is a new technology that would focus upon the new technology with reduction in cost. So it would reduce the cost, nuclear fuel. AIDS drug trial. Now AIDS that we talked about, that AIDS is a kind of disease which has no cure. And it is a very dangerous, life-threatening disease. So the vaccine and drug of HIV/AIDS has been invented and it is on trial. South Africa has launched a multi-year trial of a vaccine that might save millions of lives and help put an end to AIDS. So it has launched it and it is still on trial. So it's the first AIDS vaccine trial in 7 years and hopes are high, not just in Africa but around the world. To develop a vaccine, scientists find a way to mimic the virus so the body makes an immune response to protect itself, which is why this is considered to be a very, very good breakthrough in the field of science and technology to have a vaccine against AIDS and HIV. Now coming to the next portion of our current affairs, it's mergers, acquisitions and MOU. SBI has taken certain initiatives. The edible oil firm by the name of Ruchi Soya Industry, in association with the State Bank of India, has launched an initiative to provide banking assistance to farmers. Very, very important. So this is by the name of social inclusion. This can be included within social inclusion and increase in agricultural production of things. So Ruchi Soya Industry is an oil firm. It is working in association with SBI, State Bank of India, to launch an initiative to provide banking assistance to farmers, all the banking services. So banking assistance will be provided to soya bean farmers in Indore, Samver, Manglia, Ujjain Mandis in Madhya Pradesh, all these places. It will expand the scheme further to states like Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat. Under this initiative, the Kisan Kalyan Ayojan, this company will help farmers to open bank accounts, procure the produce directly from farmers at the right place, and ensure that farmers get their payment immediately through the internet banking. So all these things can work if these industries and if these associations or mergers with SBI work in a proper manner, like it is working in Madhya Pradesh and subsequently in other states. And this particular Yojana, the Kisan Kalyan Ayojan, this would help the farmers seek the internet banking as well as bank account opening. This is an initiative by the SBI. The FB investment program, FB Start program, which is Facebook, will invest $40,000 in Indian fashion startup by the name of Kout Lout. So this is an investment program by Facebook. The program was launched by Facebook last year to help entrepreneurs with their startups by providing sufficient funds and services to help grow their business. The startup will also receive mentorship from the engineering teams of Facebook. All the engineering teams of Facebook will be providing assistance to these startups where they would be granting funds to it and how to use those funds. India-Qatar agreement. There was an agreement between India and Qatar, two separate countries. India and Qatar, they signed 4 agreements on visas, provision of visa to either of the country people, cyberspace, how to use the cyberspace, and investments following the delegation level talks. So they had signed these deals, and the agreement allows holders of diplomatic, special, official passport holders of the two countries visa-free travel between the two countries. So they can travel between two countries and it would be a visa-free travel. Agreement in cyberspace security was also signed between the MHA of India and the Ministry of Interior for Qatar. So it is cyberspace security and visas. The visa would increase the business travel as well as the diplomatic travel between two countries. It might also increase the tourism travel between two countries, between India and Qatar. Coming to awards and achievements segment. So an Indologist award, Distinguished Intelligence Award, the President of India, Pranab Mukherjee, presented the second ICCR Distinguished Indologist Awards to Professor Yu Long Yu, Professor Yu Long Yu of People's Republic of China. So this person from PRC by the name of Yu Long Yu was presented this Indologist Award. Now, why is this award given? Distinguished Indologist Award has been instituted by the ICCR to recognize eminent Indologists working abroad who have made outstanding contribution to the study of teaching, to the field of study, to the field of teaching, research of India's philosophy, India's thought, history, art, culture, language, literature, civilization, etc. So each of these awards have been given. Each of these fields have been given these awards, the Indologist Award. The first Distinguished Indologist Award was presented to Professor Heinrich Freyrer von Stichon of Germany last year. So he was given this award first, and now Professor Yu Long Yu has been given this award on the research that he has conducted. Usain Bolt, news pertaining to achievement of Usain Bolt. You already know the person. He is a great champion and a very fast athlete. He won an unprecedented 6th IAAF Male Athlete of the Year Award. So please remember, he is the male athlete and he has won the Male Athlete of the Year Award 2016. Ethiopian Alma Zayana picking up the female award after her record setting of 10,000 meters gold in Rio. She has won this female award of this segment. So Bolt has already been awarded with the same award in all these years. And he has always won this award for being the best male athlete for the sprint that he does. LeBron James. Basketball player LeBron James has been chosen as the Sports Illustrated Sportsperson of the Year. So he is the second athlete to win this award twice. LeBron James. LeBron James represents the team of Cleveland Cavaliers to the 2016 NBA title and was named NBA Finals Most Valuable Player. So it is a sport of basketball, very famous sport of basketball, and NBA is a club. So under NBA, this person, LeBron James, has been named as the best athlete and the most illustrated sportsperson of the year. So Davis Cup is a cup which is given in the field of tennis. This year, Argentina has won its maiden Davis Cup. First time it has won the Davis Cup by defeating Croatia in the final. So Davis Cup is a premier international team event in men's tennis. And this year it was won by Argentina. Sachin Tendulkar's autobiography, Playing It My Way, has won the prestigious Crossword Book of the Year Award. So Crossword is a very famous, it is a bookshop, it is a very famous bookshop which is around the country. And its Book of the Year Award is given to the bestseller and most appreciated book, which was given to Playing It My Way, an autobiography of Tendulkar. So this book is penned by Boria Majumdar by taking inputs from Sachin Tendulkar. Earlier, this book made it into the Limca Book of World Records for being the best-selling book. Hence, remember the name of the book. It is Playing It My Way. Again, Magnus Carlsen has won the World Chess Championship of 2016 by defeating Sergei Karjakin from Russia. Carlsen belongs to the country Norway and has secured the third consecutive World Championship title. So this person is very, very young. He is in mid-20s and he has also already become a chess champion of the world, and that too 3 years in a row. So take motivation from him and study very, very hard. Magnus Carlsen, World Chess Championship. Srinidhi Shetty has been announced as the Miss Supernational 2016 at an international beauty pageant. The beauty pageant is held every year, and Srinidhi Shetty earlier than this had qualified for the Miss India Universe pageant earlier this year, where she won the title Miss Diva Supernational. Now she has won Miss Supernational 2016. So it's a big achievement for our country. Now, leader in technology space. All of you may have heard about Elon Musk. He is the founder of SpaceX and Tesla, two separate companies which are working on separate missions. He has been named as the most admired leader in the technology space in a survey conducted by a VC firm, First Round Capital, involving over 700 startup founders. So Elon Musk is working upon making an electric battery-operated car, and he has been working on certain space rockets to be launched to space. Amazon's Jeff Bezos emerged as the second most admired technology leader, followed by Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg and Apple's Steve Jobs. So this is the list in chronology. Elon Musk stands first. Remember the name of the VC firm that has announced it. It's First Round Capital. This is a very proud moment for India, where Indian women's cricket team has won this cup Asia Cup T20 after beating Pakistan in the final of regional tournament by 17 runs. It was played in Bangkok and India defeated the other teams as well as Pakistan in the group stages. Mithali Raj had scored top for India in the Asia Cup final against Pakistan. This is India's sixth successive Asia Cup title. So it's a moment of pride where Indian women's cricket team has got recognition to the entire country. Congratulations, Team India. Helen Keller Award. A person by the name of Sanjeev Sonawane has been given this award, the Helen Keller Award, in the category as acting as a role model supporter for increased employment opportunities for disabled persons category. So employment opportunities for disabled persons where this person, Sanjeev Sonawane, being a blind person, a visually impaired person, acts as an educationist. And he has developed educational program for hundreds of blind people. He is the head of education and extension department at the Savitribai Phule, Pune University. And which is why he has been granted this very prestigious award, the Helen Keller Award, Sanjeev Sonawane. Now coming to the last segment, it is about the appointments. Dr. Karan Singh has been appointed as the chairperson of the governing board of Auroville Foundations. He was earlier also the chairperson of this body and now he has been renominated. He is acting as a Rajya Sabha member as well. So Auroville Foundation. Auroville is a city of Dawn. It's an experimental township in Villupuram district in the state of Tamil Nadu. So please remember this fact about Auroville. It is considered as a city of Dawn and it's a township on an experimental basis in this district, Villupuram district of Tamil Nadu, India, with some parts in UT of Puducherry. So please remember the name Auroville Foundation. It is considered to be a statutory body by the Government of India under Auroville Foundation Act of 1988. Director General's appointment, the Lieutenant General A.K. Bhatt was appointed as the DGMO, Director General of Military Operations. The Lieutenant General Bhatt will succeed Lieutenant General Ranbir Singh. So please remember the name of both the people. A.K. Bhatt is now the successor of DGMO and acting DGMO and General Ranbir Singh was the predecessor or his predecessor. You can follow us on Facebook at our official handle, All India GK Official. You can also visit our website for the regular MCQs that we will be putting on the basis of whatever we have given in terms of current affairs in this video. So the 1st to 7th of December, current affairs have been given in this particular video. And all the current affairs will carry certain MCQs. So if you really liked the video, then you can specifically attempt the MCQs which will be beneficial for all the students who are appearing for the exams like the banking exam, SSC exam and the UPSC examinations. So please visit the website to attempt these MCQs. You can also follow us on the Telegram channel by the same name of All India GK. So please comment and subscribe to our YouTube channel and write to us on Facebook or under this video if you require any other particular type of video on our channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye.